Bullets YouTube channel.
Hurry up now, tell us why you're here.
Lightning McQueen's new crew chief is Bill Racelot. Best of luck to him. Now to starting grid. Tony Gasward will start at pole position with Billy Oil Changer to his outside. Row 2 has Lightning McQueen, who just got his new crew chief, and Chuck Hicks! Row 3 has Joe Brickcheck and Elliot Draftler, hoping not to crash, to his outside. Row 4 has The King and Rusty Wheelhouse. Both are retiring at the end of the season. Row 5 has Kevin Karvik and Sage Vanderspin. Both have been inconsistent across the careers. Row 6 has Moira Clutchburn, who's won one Piston Cup, and Kevin Shiftright, whose father won 3. Row 7 has Dale Carrot, the 2-time Florida 500 champion, and The King, 5-time Florida 500 champion. Row 8 has Jeff Corvette, hoping not to crash again, and Brian Vickars to his outside. Row 9 has Michael Kartrip and Greg Beeple, both looking for their next win at the Florida International Speedway. Row 10 has Casey Corner and Ernie Gearson. Row 11 has win for Bradford Rutherford, looking for win number 2, and Bobby Cabani to his outside. Row 12 has Mark Carton, a very nice car, and Eugene Kobereski, a very mean car. Row 13 has Johnny Blamer, hoping not to crash, and Misty Motocross. Kowal Scruggs won't complain. Row 14 has Ryan Newcar and Kurt Buschtire to his outside. Row 15 has Casey Gears and Hall Ingus, the 1992 Piston Cup champion, to his outside. Row 16 is Jeremy Carfield. The cart started on the pole last race, and Kyle Buschtire, the runner-up of that race. Row 17 is Jamie McCary and Carl Edwards to his outside, looking for a second win. Row 18 has Ricky Flood looking for his third win, and Todd Marcus looking for his first win. Row 19 has 2-1-time champions, Chuck Armstrong and Matt Karzith. Dale Earnhardt Jr. starts all the way back in row 20 with Ken Schrader to his outside. Row 21 has Ruby Easy Oaks and Jeff Burnton. Both have won races before. And starting in 43rd is Darren Ledfoot, who qualifies infrequently. And these 9 cars fail to qualify. Sadly, they did. Now, onto the race. Tony Gasward would lead for the first 103 laps?! How does any car lead for that long? And then, Chuck Hicks is 13th as of lap 103. When he wrecks Kurt Buschtire, Kevin Shiftright, Mark Carton, Michael Kartrip, Billy Oil Changer, Sage Vanderspin, Case, and Casey Gears, who's out for the season. The King would take the lead after the restart, leading for only one lap before he'd lose the lead to Elliot Draftler, who'd lead for 3 laps before his teammate Dale Carrot would take the lead for 2 laps. And then Tony Gasward retakes the lead, leading all the way until lap 141, where he'd lose the lead to Casey Corner. He'd lead for 4 laps before Tony Gasward would retake the lead, leading for 102 laps! How does any car lead for over 100 laps twice? And then the mean green car, Tickex, would be 21st as of lap 246, where he wrecks his rival Kyle Buschtire, Johnny Blamer, Carl Edwards, Ruby Easy Oaks, Bobby Carbani, Greg Beeple. Why? And then Lightning McQueen would take the lead for 2 laps before Tony Gasward would be for 252 laps! How does any car be for the whole second half of the race? How does any car lead for 252 laps? And then he, of course, wins the 2005 Gasprin 400. Corey Turbowitz wonders how Tony Gasward could have such a dominant race. And here was Tony Gasward's response. And here is the top 10 of the 2005 Gasprin 400. And here is the top 20 in points. All the King needs to do to keep his points lead is finish ahead of Tony Gasward next race.
Remember to press the notifications button, which goes ring, ring, ring after you press it. And lightning strikes back! And that's as if you subscribed, of course. And thank you for watching this entire video!
I don't get how Tony Gassward could lead every lap except for 9 laps. And the 19th race of 2005 will be coming out soon enough.